Robert, I think your topic you gave me today is something different. Why I am not a conservative?
Yes. Why I am not a conservative is why this panel is called the Uninvited. And this is the key issue here. We have heard on this somewhat eclectic panel today a variety of important issues. And I ask you, why is any of this controversial? Why is any of this an issue? Why is this panel called the Uninvited? Why are we here instead of on the big stage talking about this front and center? Look, maybe you don't know, but Barack Obama has completely aligned this nation with the Muslim Brotherhood. He has supported all the demonstrators in the Middle East who were demonstrating on behalf of and for, it was never a democratic thing, it was never the Arab Spring, it was always an Islamic supremacist takeover. They were demonstrating on behalf of the Muslim Brotherhood and on behalf of Salafis and groups that were going to institute Islamic law in those countries. There are two sets of demonstrators that Barack Obama did not support. One was the demonstrators in Iran in 2009, and the other, the demonstrators against the Muslim Brotherhood regime now in Egypt. Now, what is the common thread there? All of the demonstrators that he supported were working to install Islamic supremacist pro-Sharia regimes, and they have. The only two that he has not supported were demonstrating against Islamic supremacist pro-Sharia regimes. Do you sense a pattern there? Barack Obama is not stupid, and we should give him credit for knowing what he's doing and for doing that on purpose. And then we're here talking about this in a panel called The Uninvited. Why? Because the loyal opposition is completely absent on this issue. Now, Steve asked me not to talk about this, and I'm going to anyway, because when you're uninvited already, you don't care.
Hold it. Hang on. No. Hang on, Robert. Hang on. I didn't say not. Hang on. I didn't say not to invite. Not. But I don't want. We no need to have personal.
There's
invective.
No personal attacks. I don't know Grover Norquist personally. I met him once. I met Suhail Khan twice. I don't know these guys. What I do know is that they're completely in bed with the same people Barack Obama is listening to draft the Muslim Brotherhood positive foreign policy of the United States and domestic policy as well. I do know that. There is abundant evidence for it. I don't have time to go into it. Go look it up online. Look up Norquist's ties to Abdulrahman al-Amudi, who was the leading moderate Muslim. You want to talk about moderate Muslims? Abdulrahman al-Amudi was the moderate Muslim. There was no greater moderate than Abdulrahman al-Amudi. Everybody who chases after moderate Muslims to show that they're not anti-Islam and anti-Muslim, they wanted to get their picture taken with Abdulrahman al-Amudi in the 90s. Where's Abdulrahman al-Amudi now? Why isn't he here so we can get our picture taken with him? Well, he's in prison for funding al-Qaeda. And his protege and his friend, Suhail Khan, he's here. Go get a picture taken with him. And Grover Norquist, who works with Suhail Khan, he is the one who made it so that Pamela Geller and I are here on this panel called The Uninvited. And I won this award. I didn't ask for this award. I didn't campaign for this award. I don't even care about this award, to tell you the truth. It's very nice. It's a great honor. But it's not a big deal that there was a vote for the People's Choice Blog Award, and my website, Jihad Watch, visit it regularly, www.jihadwatch.org. It won. It won this award overwhelmingly. And they said, you will get this banner on the Tea Party website, and you will get these links and all these things, and it didn't happen. And it didn't happen, and it didn't happen, and it didn't happen. And so finally, I called John Hawkins of Right Wing News, and I said, why is none of this happening? And he says, well, there's a little problem. You want to make sure you don't talk about Grover Norquist and Suhail Khan when you get the award. Okay. He said, were you going to talk about Grover Norquist and Suhail Khan? And I said, I wasn't planning on it, but I am now. This is not personal. This has to do with the fact that the United States government is sold out to the Muslim Brotherhood. Listen, don't take my word for it. There was an Egyptian paper, Rosa El Youssef, look it up. And they were saying that because of Muslim Brotherhood infiltration into the United States government, it was a December article, it's recent, they said, because of this infiltration, the United States has been transformed from the foremost opponent of Islam to the foremost enabler of the Muslim Brotherhood. They said it. I didn't say it. Okay, so Barack Obama is down with that. Fine. Where's the opposition? Can we get an opposition here? Amen.
So Robert, in 1 minute, in one minute, can you summarize why you're not a conservative?
Well, that's exactly why I'm not a conservative. Obviously, I am a conservative like Andrew Breitbart. I am a conservative like anybody who wants to defend the constitutional principles of the freedom of speech, the equality of rights of all people, all these things that are threatened by Sharia. But suddenly, that's so toxic, that's so controversial, that's so evil, that the only way I can get here, even to the conservative political action conference, is on a panel called The Uninvited. This is not about me. This is about a much larger problem that has to do with the fact that the opposition, look, go back and play on YouTube Mitt Romney's third debate with Obama and how Obama kept saying that he was going to aid the Syrian jihadis and he had done this in Libya, aiding those jihadis and aiding jihadis left and right. And all Mitt Romney could say was, yes, I agree, let's do it. He kept agreeing with it. Where is the opposition? If we do not fashion an opposition to this at this point, then the consequences are going to be staggering and beyond anybody's calculation at this point.
Thank you, Robert.